Hi everyone, welcome back to the channel. In this video, I will be showing you how you could leverage the new issues add-ins for Navisworks and Revit. The add-ins could help you in your coordination workflows by eliminating the need of other software packages. Using the Autodesk Construction Cloud as your common data environment, the issues add-ins can join the best of each environment into one seamless workflow. This video is longer than usual. Please use the timestamps in the description to skip through sections if necessary. Let's begin. What are these issues add-ins? The Navisworks Coordination Issues add-in allows you to batch create issues in Navisworks and save them to ACC, manage status and respond to issues in Navisworks, group and organize Navisworks clashes, save and edit model coordination aggregated views directly from Navisworks. Automatic NWF management facilitates multi-Navisworks user workflows and includes Navisworks data merging. The Revit Issues add-in allows you to view and create issues within Revit, manage status and respond to issues in Revit. Issues created in ACC Docs, ACC Model Coordination, or Navisworks can be managed using the Revit Issues add-in. With this round-trip workflow, issues are created in either the Autodesk Construction Cloud, Navisworks, and/or Revit, and are viewable and actionable on any of these apps, bringing the best of each environment to your next project. Leveraging issues settings, project administrators can create issue categories and types, custom attributes, templates, and control issue permissions. These settings can also be incorporated into ACC project templates for fast deployment in future projects. But first, what do we need to start using these add-ins? For Navisworks, we need Navisworks Manage or Simulate, the Autodesk Desktop Connector, the Navisworks Coordination Issues add-in from the Autodesk App Store, ACC Docs and ACC Model Coordination Access. For Revit, we need Revit version 22 or higher, issues add-in for your specific Revit version available on your Autodesk account, access to ACC Docs. All relevant links are available in the video description below. Let's start with the Navisworks Coordination Issues add-in. Step 1, create a coordination space on ACC Model Coordination. For the Navisworks Coordination Issues add-in to synchronize with ACC and Revit, a coordination space needs to be created. In the ACC Model Coordination module, click on Settings, select Create Coordination Space, add a name and select a folder for this space. The folder should contain the Navisworks or Revit models you wish to coordinate. Step 2. Load your model or view into Navisworks. In Navisworks, create a new project and click on the Coordination tab. In later versions of Navisworks, you can also use the Coordination panel on the home screen. Select Open and browse to the ACC project where you created the coordination space. If you saved a federated view in ACC Model Coordination, click on Views. Otherwise, choose the models you want to use for coordination. Note that the models available are the 3D views published from Revit. Step 3. Save as NWF file or view on ACC. You are now able to save this view as NWF file or a new view on ACC. The view will be available under the View tools in ACC Model Coordination. If saving it as an NWF file, you can take advantage of multi-Navisworks user workflows and data merging. Step 4, utilize your common clash workflow. This step involves common Navisworks clash detection workflows. You can use existing appearance profiles, clash tests, and other workflow elements as per your team's standards. On screen, I will demonstrate how you can apply existing search sets, appearance profiles, and clash tests to perform your usual Navisworks clash detection. You can also use the group results function to quickly group clashes according to the group criteria you set up. Grouping clashes will reduce the amount of issues you create, since you can create a single issue from a group of clashes. Step 5. Create issues from clashes. Create issues from single clashes or from clash groups as a single issue. Right-click on the clash or clash group, select Actions, and click on Create Issues. You can batch create issues by selecting multiple clashes or clash groups. Make sure you set viewpoint to auto update. Step 6, fill attributes and create issues. The issues side panel will open, fill in the required attributes and click create. The issue title will be automatically assigned from the name of the clash test, clash group name. If using an issue template, the template name will be added as prefix. To accelerate the issue creation process, leverage the issue tool settings and templates on ACC. Step 7, manage and review issues. For every created issue, a pin is shown on the model. The pin color will depend on the status attribute. When selected, the pin will also display the issue ID. Newly created issues will default to the open status. You can add additional screenshots as reference to the issue by clicking on the camera icon. Use the arrows to cycle through issues. The activity log will track every action performed on each issue, for example, status change, change in attributes, etc. Select the issue or issue group, right-click, Actions, and click on Create Issues. The add-in will create issues from the selected clashes or clash groups. Depending on the amount of issues created at once, this process might take a few seconds. Using the Issues side panel, you can review the created issues, fill in attributes, take additional snapshots that will be saved as references, and cycle through the issues using the up-down arrows. Don't forget to save your work either as a NWF file or a view on model coordination. Now let us see how the Revit Issues add-in works. Do you need a coordination space when using the Revit Issues add-in? To view and create issues in Revit, a coordination space in ACC model coordination is not necessary. A coordination space is only required if clash detection is performed directly in ACC model coordination, or you are using the coordination issues add-in for Navisworks. Issue changes will sync automatically across environments. If an issue is created on a model in ACC Docs, this issue will be visible in Revit and vice versa. If Navisworks is used in the workflow, issues can be loaded from copies of the model and are aggregated in the Revit view. For example, if the coordination space is using the shared folder as opposed to the WIP folder. In this example, I will show you how you can create an issue on a 3D view of a model on ACC Docs and how it reflects on the model in Revit. Similarly, I will create an issue in Revit, which will then be visible in the ACC Docs model. Let's have a look at the Issues tab. In the Issues tab, click on Overview to get an issue status summary. If using ACC model coordination for clash detection, clash tolerance, and clash table will also display information. To view and create issues in Revit, click on Manage Issues button to open the Issues side panel. If issues have been created in Navisworks or ACC, these issues will also be listed on the panel if the corresponding model is selected. Use the Associated Model dialog to select the models from where you want to display issues. This is particularly useful if issues are being created on WIP or shared models using AC model coordination or the coordination issues add-in for Navisworks. When reviewing issues, clicking on an issue will make the Revit view orbit and focus on the issue as captured on the issue thumbnail. Use the selection box command to isolate the element for easier review and resolution. When changing the status of an issue, the pin color will change accordingly, and it will be updated across all environments. The same will happen with any other issue attribute. Now, let us check out what happened on ACC while we were using the issues add-ins. You can review and manage created issues on ACC. The Issues tool is available in almost all ACC modules. All issues created through the Issues add-ins will be visible in the Issues tool on ACC. Administrators can manage issues visibility on ACC by accessing the Issues permissions settings. Issues on AC can be exported as BCF, PDF, or Excel. Issue status changes in ACC will be reflected in Navisworks and Revit when using the Issues add-ins. For this last part of the video, I will address some frequently asked questions. Are issues linked to element IDs? If a model object was selected during issue creation, the issue will be linked to the element ID. If a model object was not selected or was being sectioned before issue creation, then it won't be linked. Additionally, non-model objects such as annotations and legends can't be linked to issues. What happens if an element ID changes? The Revit Issues add-in supports object highlighting, which relies on element IDs. If an element ID changes, the issue push pin would still be in the correct position, but the affected object would no longer be highlighted. If I move an element associated with an issue, does the issue push pin move as well? No. The push pin position will not be updated if you move an element. What happens if the element an issue is linked to gets deleted? Will the issue be deleted as well? No, the issue will not disappear. A message will be displayed to explain that the associated element is not available. Does the Revit Issues add-in consume tokens? No tokens will be consumed. Which languages are available for the add-in? The add-in is available in all languages supported by Revit. Does the Revit Issues add-in support 2D sheets and views? For issues created on 2D drawing sheets, push pins will be displayed, but there is no support for issues created on other 2D view and sheet types, such as column schedules, legends, reports, view plans, section views, drafting views, and table views. And that's it. Congratulations, you made it to the end of the video. Let me know in the comments if you have any questions about the issues add-ins. In a future video, I will address the ACC Issues tool in more detail. Until then, goodbye.